everybody, and welcome back to Let's Quick Play Pikmin. In the last episode, we started the game off here at the Impact Site, and in this episode, we will be heading to the second area of the game, the Forest of Hope. Hooray for masked load times. Anyway. My dolphin has returned to the surface along with the Pikmin's onions. Being alone on this strange planet makes me somewhat uneasy, so I shall call the Pikmin out of the onion. All I need to do is stand in the light beneath the onion and press A. Yep, that's all you gotta do. We're obviously just going to pull out all 25 of our Pikmin. We're also going to harvest this food pellet before we do anything. And then we're going to take a gander at that grass. You will see why in a bit. Come on. Now, as you can see at the top of the screen, there is a time thing scale, or sun scale thing. That is the measure for how long days are. As I said before, days are 13 minutes. Now, when you get near this grass, your Pikmin will latch onto it themselves. No, no, no! Oh, you jerks. The Pikmin will pull it themselves, and you'll see yellow nectar pop out of it, and when the Pikmin drink the nectar, they will become flower Pikmin. Unfortunately, these little red Pikmin decided to be greedy and take all of the nectar for themselves. Oh my god, almost everybody. Let's see if we can get more. The problem with nectar is that a single Pikmin can drink up an entire unit of nectar himself. Which is so annoying. Okay, we got no more leaves. Let's take out this wall. You just want to direct your Pikmin onto it using the D-pad, down on the D-pad. C-stick in the Gamecube version. And, I guess I'll just rant about something while they're doing that. Yeah, this Pikmin AI in this game is just not very well programmed. It's a lot better in the second game, although even in that game, they still take the shortest route. With items that they're holding and taking back to the onion, they still take the shortest route back to the onion, which is not always the safest route. Believe me, it's not good. In that way, I guess you do kind of have to play a little bit more strategy to predict what they're going to do. Alright, come on, guys. There you go, good boys. Now, these right here, these little guys are, I think they're dwarf bulborbs. Or they're just bulborbs. I'm pretty sure they're dwarf. These are essentially the Goombas of the game. They're extremely, common. Very weak. You can kill them instantly by throwing a Pikmin, any Pikmin of any color, directly on top of them. Ooh, five pellet. Okay, we're gonna do is 1, 2, 3. They require three Pikmin to carry it. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Carry it back. Okay, whatever. Take that. Alright, we're basically going to try and get up about 50 Pikmin. That is our goal. We want about 50 because... Oh, no, 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 no! Oh, saved it. Saved your life. We need 10. Alright, there's a part right there, but we can't really carry it. You don't get to carry it back because you were too greedy. Well, you know what, actually, I do need these guys to hurry. So, take that back, guys. I got one little guy left with me. Alright, good, there's still some nectar left over. At least then I don't have to worry about every... Also, I'd like to mention, before doing anything else, leaf Pikmin have a tendency to trip a lot for no reason, and it is quite possibly one of the most annoying things in this game. Oh, we got 60 Pikmin already? Oh, okay. That's good. That is good enough for me. Oh god, we gotta hurry. It's already there. Jeez. Alright, come on, guys. But yeah, they tend to be extremely annoying. This is pretty much, 60 is about all the reds will need for a while. That hardly got any Pikmin, but okay, we got tons of Steves. Alright, we're gonna want 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Or 7, 8, 9, 10. Or 11. Then we want the rest of them taking this back. Alright, guys. Take that back. And then what we're going to be doing is getting a second ship part. That is the first ship part. As you can see, it is the Eternal Fuel Dynamo. This should light things up. No more candles for me. It's his electricity, his fuel. Although I don't know how his engine took off without any fuel then. But let's not question that so that this game doesn't crash. This game's never crashed on me now that I think about it. They'll probably get it back before these Pikmin sprout up. Once they get it back, we are going to, or once we're ready to go, we'll be getting, we'll be killing off one of our first big enemies and then, getting a second ship part, and that'll probably be it, other than one more thing we're going to be doing for today. The Eternal Fuel Dynamo. I have now recovered 2 out of 30 parts. If I can find just 3 more, I should be able to increase my ship's capabilities. What that means is... Oh, idiot. What that means is if he increases his ship's flying abilities, he'll be able to go to a different area. Since you have 5 more parts, we'll have another area to go to. Let's grab these guys. Alright, now what we're going to want to do is we're going to want to toss up 50 onto this ledge. Not 40, 50. Or actually, you know what? I'll probably put up 55. So we want to have 15 left in our party. Now, water, as you can see over there, will harm your Pikmin. They will drown in it because they don't know how to swim. However, Olimar is in a spacesuit. Oh, and it's noon. Olimar is in a spacesuit, so water does not harm him. He breathes fine in it. Okay, can you please get up the ledge? Alright, now let's go over here. This right here is a spotty bulb orb. Not related to the dwarf bulb orb at all, actually. Which is very strange. They're completely different species. It's basically the caretaker. Alright, now what we're going to want to do is... BOMB RUSH HIM! GO! Come on guys, yeah! That's how you do it. And this is the Shock Absorber. This apparatus counteracts the shaking and swaying that normally occurs during flight. It's smooth sailing with this in place, usually. This caw takes 30 Pikmin, okay. That'll take 30, and then I'll just have the rest of these guys carrying. What the heck? I had 30 carrying it, unless I lost one Pikmin inexplicably. There we go. No, you were not carrying that back. Alright, now we want these guys to hurry back, because we're going to have to take out this spotty Bulborb next. Oh my god. What are you doing? Don't go close. Don't go close. Okay. They're good. They're good. Alright, guys. Oh, damn, I got a lot of them. 12 Pikmin from a spotty Bulborb? That's pretty good. Alright. And now we're not gonna harvest that other spotty Bulborb because we want to save it for a different thing. Shocker's already, I've now recovered 3! Oh, we need 5 out of 30 parts in Hill. And boom. You boys can come with me! Alright. Let's get going. We need to take out this guy fast. We also need to get that gate over there down really quick. Ready, guys? Bomb rush! Yeah, that's how you do it. Alright, let's take this bridge out really quickly. While they're doing that, I'm going to go back and get those other two Pikmin that were sprouted. Or seeded, I guess. Come on, guys. Come on, Steves. No, I can't take any more out. I have all of them on the field. Let's go. You can also bear in mind you can hold a Leaf Pikmin with you to kind of make the traveling go a little bit faster. Good job. Alright, now watch out for this one, because if this thing cries... Oh my god, no! What are you doing? Ah! Oh. God, it's already afternoon. I want to hurry. Alright. What? Go to sleep, go to sleep, go to sleep, go to sleep, go to sleep. Okay, good. Go! Yeah, that's how you do it. Alright, now we're gonna take our reds over here so that they don't cause any trouble. You, get up. Stay there. And over here, we're going to discover a yellow onion! As you would guess, yellow onion sprouts a yellow Pikmin. Come on. There you go. Yaw! And he has ears. Yellow Pikmin are very aerodynamically designed. They have ears, which means they can be thrown the farthest and the highest, as you'll see. Watch. They'll be thrown the farthest, and they can be thrown the highest, which adds a little bit more strategy than just red Pikmin, which, actually, I'll have to describe this now, too. Red Pikmin's damage, red Pikmin are the strongest Pikmin in the game. Red Pikmin can, have a damage multiplier of 1.5, while yellow Pikmin are just 1. Alright, 5 of you guys. Take it back. Hurry up. We want to sprout as many yellows as we can with the time that we have left. Yes, as soon as you'll notice that we have 101 Pikmin in existence, but only 100 on the field. You can only have 100 Pikmin on the field at any given time. It's almost sundown. Ugh, better hurry. Okay, stop. We need to get these guys on this Bulborb. Alright, unintentional Pikmin 2 reference. Come on, guys. Come on, hurry up. Hurry up! Stop looking at it! We must hurry! Ah! Hurry up, hurry up, hurry up. Take this back. Alright, now what we should be doing now is, gathering our reds! Come here! And these yellers. Okay. Well, they're not gonna make it back. Alright. Well, we got all 100 in our squad. The reason that you want to do that is because, like I said before, if you don't have all Pikmin on the field in your squad, they will be left behind unless they are at your home base or around your spaceship. So please be wary of that. I also like to watch this scene at the end. You can skip it, but the end of day scene is impacted by various things you've done throughout the day. So, I got everything I wanted to get done though. It's pretty cool. Never able to get that many yellow Pikmin in one day on the second day before. 2 days since impact. It appears that many of my ship's parts have landed in this region. If I can just recover the parts of my radar, I should be able to use my radar screen. How that would improve my chances. Then I'd only have to press plus to locate my parts. Yep, there seem to be many hostile life forms here. If I'm attacked and my spacesuit takes damage, I must return to my ship, stand in front of it, and press A to make suit repairs. As I explore, I must pay attention to my suit's damage meter in the bottom left corner of the screen. What he means is, you can stand in front of your spaceship and press A, and you will repair damage. That's pretty much it. You'll heal yourself. Oh, we got 84 reds. Whoa, sprouted 94 today. Jeez. 35 yellows is pretty good. You don't need a whole lot of yellows in this game. They're not all that useful, so that's pretty good. Alright, now, yeah, I guess that's it for this episode. In the next episode on day 3, we'll be heading back to the Forest of Hope to grab, hopefully, a few more ship parts. I'll see you guys then.
ほったかされてまた手投げられて、でも私たちあなたに従い尽くします。